welcome to our annual STARS recognition and award celebration. My name is Dr. Krista Jengard, and I'm the President and CEO here at the IWK Health Center. I'd like to acknowledge that I'm speaking from Mi'kma'ki, the traditional unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq Nation. For the use of the land, we are very grateful. As with so many other things in this weird year that is 2020, our usual award ceremony, which we do in person, can't be done that way. So we have changed to the virtual world. Not so much fun, perhaps not as many hugs and elbow bumps, but appropriate during this time of the global pandemic. What hasn't changed, even if this is different, is the pleasure that we have in acknowledging some of the wonderful and inspirational staff and the IWK community, and putting some spotlights on those people who do wonderful work all of the time on behalf of our patients and families here at the IWK. So today's ceremony, be it virtually, is all about celebrating the commitment of those people in their career to healthcare and to the invaluable contributions that you make all of the time to the patient care and family care that we deliver here at the IWK. On behalf of the Board of Directors, our staff, and the entire IWK family, my congratulations to each of the winners of the awards. You're all very deserving individuals. Many people were nominated. Unfortunately, we can't always have all of the nominations come through to win the awards, but all of those individuals deserve our thanks and our recognition at this time. Thank you to everyone who works day to day to make the world here at the IWK the wonderful place that it is. The first awards, there's two of them, are for the Allied Health Preceptor Awards. Allied Health Preceptor Awards are supported by interprofessional practice and the learning team. They have been established to recognize the outstanding contributions of preceptors to learning and professional practice here at the IWK. This year, these awards are going to Dr. Susan Jerrott of Community Health, Mental Health and Addictions, and Anthony Hickey of Respiratory Therapy. Dr. Susan Jerrott was nominated by IWK psychologist Dr. Jillian Filliter. Dr. Filliter could not join us today, so psychologist Marcie Balch has stepped in to talk on behalf of the nomination.
I am thrilled that Dr. Susan Jerrott was the winner of the Preceptor Award within STARS Week. She exemplifies all things that this award is meant to really capture and recognize in her work. I am sad to say that she also got this a little bit as a lifetime achievement award, as she then left the IWK for a position doing much more of these kind of skills at NSHA. So much of Dr. Susan Jerrott's career exemplified why she deserves this reward. When Dr. Filliter put forward the nomination letter, she highlighted a couple of pieces that I think are really, really strong in terms of recognizing Dr. Jerrott. So one of the sections reads, "I have no doubt that I'm a better clinician, colleague, mentor, leader, and person because of Dr. Jerrott's excellence as a preceptor. Dr. Jerrott is a preceptor who is able to adapt her supervision, mentorship style to the training level and interpersonal style of the person that she's working with to ensure a positive growth experience. Dr. Jerrott is also a strong, effective, and fair leader who fosters strong team cohesion, not only creating an excellent learning environment for trainees, but also providing a model for psychology leadership. And finally, Dr. Jerrott has served as a preceptor and mentor to countless psychology practicum students, a decade's worth of residents as director of clinical training, and clinicians from a range of disciplines in the numerous other leadership roles she's taken on in her time at the IWK. She exemplifies all of the characteristics of excellence that the Allied Health Preceptor Award is designed to recognize, and I cannot think of a more worthy recipient for this award." And I would just echo those sentiments in that Dr. Jerrott was my director of clinical training when I was here as a resident 10 years ago, and is a big reason for why I stayed and am now the professional practice leader for psychology. I just say congratulations, Susan. 2020 has been one hell of a ride. And in this time, of course, you left us and started a new job. I wish you all the best of luck in that new role. And just know that the IWK is better for all of the time that you did give us when you were here. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Balch. And now our winner, Dr. Susan Jarrett, will say a few words.
To first of all just say I'm so grateful to the IWK and to the STARS committee for this award. I worked at the IWK for 20 years and this is definitely one of the most meaningful things that has happened for me at the IWK. An especially special award for me because I believe that clinical training is what produces the best future clinical care for all the children and adolescents and families that are worked with at the IWK. And we're creating the health center of the future every time we work with a student or a resident. So I was thrilled to receive the award. To thank all of my nominators. I especially want to thank Dr. Jillian Filliter. I worked with her as both when she was my practicum student and then she was a resident at the IWK and I really appreciate her lovely nomination for this award. I also want to thank Dr. Marcie Balch, the psychology professional practice leader, and Director Maureen Brennan, because they have both been incredibly supportive of all training initiatives at the IWK and have full recognition of the importance of training and supervision to our future workforce. I wanted to really say that I thank every student and resident that I've ever had the chance to work with in these 20 years. Each of them taught me as much as I hope I taught them, and each was willing to be brave and to go outside their comfort zone to help our children and our teens and to learn new skills. And I just wanted to finish by saying the children and the teens and the families who come to the IWK are in excellent hands because of the work that the IWK does in supporting, training our future practitioners. And this award means a lot to me and just thank you so much.
Thank you and congratulations, Dr. Jerrott. The winner of our second Allied Health Preceptor Award is a respiratory therapist, some of my favorite people from when I was working in the NICU, Anthony Hickey. Anthony was nominated by Meaghan Mamye, professor of record with Dalhousie School of Health Sciences and one of Anthony's students, Kaitlynn Blondin. Anthony and Kaitlynn were not able to join us virtually, but let's hear a little bit about them from Meaghan and Anthony, who did Anthony's nomination.
Two nominators for this award is myself. My name is Meaghan Mamye. I'm the professor of record for Dalhousie School of Health Sciences in the Respiratory Therapy Program, and I'm the professor of record for the Neonatal Pediatric Clinical Education course. But predominantly, it was one of my students, a third-year respiratory therapy student named Kaitlynn Blondin. And so she's since graduated, but she wanted to nominate Anthony for his exceptional preceptor skills. Anthony is a respiratory therapist at the IWK, and he's also a graduate of the Dalhousie School of Health Sciences Respiratory Therapy Program. Why we thought Anthony was so deserving of this award is that he already stands out as an exemplary RT. He's really valued for his patient care and his professionalism, his communication. But what we value so much about him is his ability to also be an excellent educator and leader for students. And so when students come to the IWK in the respiratory therapy program, they come with lots of experiences. And what's so great about Anthony is that he can identify that these students are adult learners and they are coming already with experiences. They want to be engaged in their learning and they have goals. And so Anthony can really individualize his preceptorship for each individual student for what they need and what they need to get out of their clinical rotation. And that's what I find so special about him. He also, if anyone doesn't know, respiratory therapy is a high-paced profession that's in the critical care environments. And so it can be hard to try and manage the intensity of your daily duties while also having a student with you. And I find that Anthony does a really great job of ensuring that the students and the patients are safe and that everybody's learning together. I just want to say congratulations to Anthony. We're really excited that he was selected for this award, and we feel he's really deserving of it. He has been so valuable for our students coming into the clinical education, and we really value how much of a role model he is for these students as they then transition to practice and become preceptors themselves. So we thank him, and we look forward to working with him because he's very important to our students' education.
Thank you, Meaghan, and congratulations to Anthony. Next is the IWK Clinical Staff Recognition Award. This award recognizes a clinical staff member who demonstrates a high level of organizational values and positively influences the work environment. The winner of this award this year is Erin Walker of Clinical Nutrition. Erin was nominated by her colleague, Elaine Woolridge. I'd like to welcome Elaine in speaking of Erin's nomination.
My name is Elaine Woolridge. I'm the clinical leader in the neurology clinic, and I nominated Erin Walker for the Clinical Staff Recognition Award. So Erin Walker is our dietitian for the neurosciences program. She is also our only ketogenic diet dietitian, which is a specialized diet for the treatment of epilepsy. And she currently takes care of about 25 patients who are on the specialized diet, along with all of her other responsibilities for the neuroscience patients. Erin is very professional and respectful of the staff and families she works with. She is the definition of a great team member and a great leader. It takes a lot of experience and a lot of creativity to work with families around sensitive issues with respect to weight, be that the child needs to gain more weight or the child may need to lose or at least not gain any more weight. And with that population, she's very creative and sensitive to the patient and to the family. She really individualizes her care for each child. She doesn't send people home and say, eat all the broccoli you can. She really looks at and talks to the child and with the parents to figure out what needs to be done to help them be the healthiest that they can be. And she has saved children's lives by doing that. There's no doubt in my mind. A dedication she has to toward the patient population on the ketogenic diet is second to none. She's more than available and resourceful in figuring out problems that we may be running into, how to problem solve. Erin will always find a solution and is very aware of the importance of her role in the health and quality of improving the quality of life for her patients. So one example of this that was kind of hit me right to the heart, we had a family that had recently immigrated to Canada, and Erin was able to help them come to terms with how to help feed their child who was having some feeding difficulties. And she really took what the parents said about the importance of feeding their child and what types of food that they have in their home and that are culturally significant to them. And she worked with that and managed to come up with a plan and a way to help feed the child that worked for everyone. So she was very sensitive to that. Again, very creative and resourceful. There's never a no, that can't work. She's always, let's see how we can make that work. And it's really improved the quality of life of that child and, frankly, all the children that she works with. So congratulations, Erin, on winning the Clinical Staff Recognition Award this year. You're one that can be nominated every single year and can win every single year. We are the whole team here in the neurology clinic, the physicians, the staff, everyone have been able to come to me even before I nominated you, even randomly, with thank goodness for Erin. She's doing such an amazing job. Can you call Erin? I need her. her for this patient. And she's always very, again, prompt and resourceful and gets back to us very quickly and works well within our team. And we could not, literally could not do what we do for our patients by improving their seizures and their quality of life without Erin.
Thank you so much, Elaine. We are now joined by our winner, Erin Walker, to accept her award.
My name is Erin Walker. I'm a clinical dietitian with the rehab team, and I work closely in the neurology team. And the award I won is the Clinical Staff Recognition Award. It means a lot to me, actually. It's nice to be recognized for your job that you do and a job that I love doing. I get to talk every day about butter and whipped cream and ketones and poop, and I love that. And I realize now that not everybody gets to say those kinds of things, so I feel really privileged to be able to do that. So it's nice to be recognized. I would like to say to Elaine, thank you for nominating me. She's my ketogenic diet partner in crime. It always feels good to be part of a team or work with a team that values your role and what you do, and to be able to see the direct effects of what you do on a patient and their family. So thank you for the nomination. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Erin, and congratulations. Next is the IWK Health Management Award. This award acknowledges managers who consistently contribute to the achievement of our mission of the organization that we have by demonstrating a high level of strategic and operational capability. This award is not just about managers, what managers do, but how they do it. I'd like to congratulate Jennifer McCarron of Community Mental Health and Addictions on winning this year's IWK Management Award. We will now hear from Jennifer's nominator, Crystal Moore, about her nomination.
Award. My name is Crystal Moore, and I am the manager and mentor to Jennifer McCarron. I nominated Jennifer because she's kind, she shows compassion, she has a strong will to understand people's values, offering encouragement, providing a great work environment, and she allows all to be engaged, interaction, respect for each other. Jennifer takes pride in her role as the clinical manager and truly has compassion for providing a safe, positive environment, not only for staff, but also for families and populations that we serve within the communities. I've been with the IWK for 12 years. I've been with Community Mental Health since for 8 years now, and she is the most effective manager that we've had. And there's been five over the last 8 years, but she came into this team wanting to support, wanting to provide a positive environment, and she's done an amazing job with it, and it's well deserved. I truly am privileged to say congratulations. This is a well-deserved award for Jennifer, and especially during these hard times with COVID-19 pandemic, she has not stopped. Our services did not stop. We continued virtually in March when we sent all of our clinicians to work at home, and she was there every day, 12 hours a day, supporting her team. And I don't even think that this award is enough to really show her how much she is appreciated. And so, just honestly, a big congratulations.
Thank you, Crystal. Now, Jennifer, can you say a few words?
I'm Jennifer McCarron. I'm the clinical manager for Community Mental Health and Addictions. And I was awarded the Manager of the Year Award. Thank you. So my nominator was Crystal Moore, and Crystal is my right-hand person. I really couldn't do my job without her, and we work very closely together, and I think that it's really special to have someone that you work very closely with nominate you for an award like this. And it's just, again, that recognition that you are doing a good job and making a difference, and other people see that and want to share it with other people too, beyond just us and our small team. So you know, I come to work every day, I try to do my best every day, and you know, I always hope that other people see that and recognize like that that that's, you know, how I'm showing up. And I think that the award is recognition that people do actually see that and, you know, see that I am coming and trying to do my best and meet expectations and move things forward. And it's just nice to be recognized for that. I would just like to say thank you to the people that I work with every day, my teams, and I've shared with some of them that this is actually really a recognition of all of the people that I work closely with and the teams, and that I really share this award with them because they do make my job so easy, frankly. And I know people might not believe that or question that, but it definitely is true from my experience. And so I feel like this is not just an award for me, but it's also recognition of CMHA and the services we provide and the people that we employ. And so it makes me proud to be part of IWK and definitely proud to be part of Mental Health and Addiction Program.
Thank you, and congratulations, Jennifer, on your great work. The next award is the IWK Patient Safety Champion Award, one of my favorites and very dear to my heart. This award is presented annually during Canadian Patient Safety Week to an IWK staff member who consistently demonstrates behaviors to improve patient safety and reduce preventable harm. Congratulations this year to Tracy Bordes of Community Health and Addictions as this year's winner. To speak about why Tracy was nominated for this award, we have two of our patient safety consultants, Natalie Nymark and Christine Pritchard.
Hi, I'm Christine Pritchard. I'm a patient safety consultant with Patient Safety and Clinical Risk.
And I'm Natalie Nymark. I'm the patient safety consultant who works with the Mental Health and Addictions Program primarily. Tracy Bordage is the clinical leader of development for the AIS and CIS teams within the Mental Health and Addictions Program. And I've had the opportunity to work closely with Tracy, and she is always questioning process and procedure, and she is always focused on how we can make things more safe for not only our patients, our families, and our clients, but also for the teams who are working with those patients, families, and clients.
We've had many people that were awesome, but Tracy stepped it up a notch and worked collaboratively to increase team and awareness in the program in mental health and addictions, and understandings of the importance of error prevention training and the expectations of the IWK in all that she does. This was a result of the noted increase in her reporting and also a conducted learning and training opportunity. She encouraged others to be safety minded and also to sign up for the safety coach workshop training. And she reinforces the knowledge, as Natalie said, and skills required in and provide the support and ongoing teaching to the groups and teams in the program that she supports. And she always does it with a smile and a positive manner, and nothing is impossible.
Tracy really exemplifies what we are looking for in safety coaches. She has changed the culture of the areas where she's working. She really takes in all of the education about safety coaches and all of the education about our error prevention programs, and just moves that work forward, and really has, I've seen a shift in the way that the teams who work with her, how they approach their safety, not just formally, but informally on the floors and in the clinics and everywhere that she's been working with them. It's really great to see that culture shift happening.
Tracy, keep up your positivity and your attitude, and contribute to ensuring patient safety is visible within the priority within the teams and the program and the health center at large in your consistent and respectful manner. And we appreciate you and always making yourself available to support patient safety initiatives.
Tracy, it's been wonderful working with you, and I love seeing how you dive right into this patient safety work and how you've really made it part of your everyday work.
Congratulations, Tracy.
Thank you to you both. Now our winner, Tracy, will have a few words to say.
I am Tracy Bordage. I am clinical leader of development for the MHA program, which is the Mental Health and Addictions program. I was nominated, and I will be receiving the award for the IWK Patient Safety Champion Award. This award is not only recognizing the work that I've done, but also the work that is done daily within the mental health and addictions program, patient safety is the forefront of our care and an initiative that is always that we as a program are always striving to improve. It feels really good to be just recognized for some of the work that we do. We do on a daily basis and we don't really think about it. I'm honored to be recognized. One of the many staff that are working hard to roll out both the Safety Coach Initiative and also the Air Prevention Program across the health center. Patient safety within the IWK is great. We are always, as a health center, really working to see new initiatives, what we can do to better expand patient safety across a continuum, and I'm just really happy that I'm part of that work.
Thank you and congratulations, Tracy. Next up is our IWK Staff Recognition Award. The recipient of this award is someone who consistently demonstrates our organizational values and positively influences the work environment, something that's been tough to do in this past year. This person role models exemplary performance and professionalism. Congratulations to this year's winner, Teresa Kim, who's a member of our Innovation Services team. Teresa was nominated by her colleague, Kaitlynn Rutledge, and unfortunately, Kaitlynn has moved on from the IWK, but instead, today we have the Director of Innovation Services, Denise Lalonde, to say a few words about our winner.
Let's say congratulations to Teresa. Teresa came to us a couple years ago from Sick Kids, and I'm thrilled that she came to Halifax, and it was actually, I found it such a pleasure to get to know and really get to know her better and meet her. And she's one of these people who's just so calm and steady and yet so passionate about her work and what the possibilities are. And so she was really something that just really helped motivate everybody and show the initiative and just such a wonderful, wonderful person. And she fit in so well within the culture of the IWK. And I can't say enough good things about her because she was just so wonderful to work with and really dedicated and reliable. And I knew that in my position that I didn't have the hands-on in the project because there's so many different competing priorities for me that I didn't have the concern that this project would not be moving forward because she was at the helm there making sure that things go forward and, you know, knew when to reach out when she needed to and just a fabulous person to work with. Teresa is one of these natural born leaders. She's not into it for how better that she can make herself, and it's not about her credit, it's about the team around her. And so Teresa definitely leads by example, and she's very inspiring to team members around them, engaging them to make sure that, you know, everyone clearly understands that their role is very important in the project, and everybody is a leader in their own way. And so she was very good at leading by example and moving up everybody else within the team to make sure that they feel important and that they both have everyone has an important role in the project.
Thank you, Denise. And now on to Teresa to accept her award.
I'm Teresa Kim, and I am a postdoc research associate at the IWK working on the Shaniki Home Project. And I was nominated for, and I guess I won, the Staff Award Recognition, or Staff Recognition Award, sorry. It was actually a huge surprise to learn that Kaitlynn actually nominated me for this award. And I only learned about it a couple weeks ago that she's done this. She never said a word that she nominated me for this award. So I guess I would want to just say a huge thank you. I hope this message gets out to her as well because she's no longer at the IWK. But I do want to thank her for taking the time out of her busy day to put in a few good words for me on this project. So I just want to say a huge thank you. Her opinion carries a lot of weight. So I'm truly, truly honored and humbled by, Kaitlynn's confidence in my abilities and for recognizing my contribution to the project. So I can't thank you enough for the personal endorsement. I feel both thrilled and honored to receive this award. It's such a wonderful way to end my time at the IWK on this project. This award represents the hard-earned skills for the last couple years that I've learned as a result, and it will help with my success. And I'm truly grateful for the opportunity to be on this project and to be nominated and to win this award. But actually, I can't accept this award alone. I want to be able to share this award with my Shaniki home teammates, both past and present. I'm actually one of the last veterans on this project that's left. They're all integral behind the scenes to get our project up and running. So our past members, Callan and Elena and Joelle, Kaitlynn, Meaghan, and our current members who were newly joined this year, Lisa and Andrea, they were such an integral part of my success on this project as well. So I feel a little guilty for accepting this award alone, but I'm also very excited to have been awarded this. Yes, thank you for giving me the chance to partake in such an amazing project at the IWK, and for being recognized for the work that I've done at the IWK. It's truly such a wonderful way to end my time here with this project and with the hospital. So this award has actually empowered me to take the next steps, solidify my decision to actually move here to Nova Scotia. I'm actually from Ontario, I'm staying here for good as far as I'm concerned. So I'm internally grateful to have been afforded the opportunity to be on the Shaniki Home Project and eternally grateful to receive the award.
Thank you, Teresa, and congratulations. So next is our Team Recognition Award. This award goes to an exemplary team that demonstrates a high level of trust and respect for each other as manifested in their positive work environment and their accomplishments of its Commons goals. It's with wonderful and great pleasure that I announce the winners, the PICU NICU Redevelopment Team. People who are very near and dear to me and very near and dear to the wonderful redevelopment that we've had in our critical care areas. This team was nominated by the directors of Women's and Newborn Health, Darlene Inglis, and the director of Critical Care and Rehabilitation Services, Stacey Burgess. We will now hear from them about why they nominated their teams.
Our nominee was a team recognition award, and it involves a number of individuals that have been working on the NICU PICU critical care redevelopment project for the last 7 years. This is a $34 million project, and it was the biggest redevelopment project that the IWK Health Center has ever embarked on, and it was completely donor funded. The team has a wide variety of individuals from different disciplines and different departments that bring their expertise to the table to ensure that we did all that we could to safely transition the neonatal intensive care unit and the pediatric intensive care unit into what the two units look like and are at this present time.
Kate, I think what's unique to this team that wasn't so involved in that work was that their dedication and commitment never wavered. They were always willing to bring their points forward. Sometimes that took great courage and vulnerability also, as they needed to make sure that they had a voice at tables. And this was all really based in being sensitive to what was most important to patients and their families. And it's really about the why we do what we do, and they seem to have that down pat. As a team, without probably doing a lot of foundation or strategic work, they just sort of fit together and became extremely committed. And I think they inspired each other, is one of the things I very much noticed about the team.
If you had to narrow it down and think about it into, I'll say three words. For me, it's commitment, the ability to put patients and families first in everything that we did, and then I would have to say collaboration, and the ability to say that team dynamics, and how we got along and how we move forward as a team for what's best for patient and families had to be at the forefront despite some of the obstacles that we were faced with and some of the difficult times. We always seem to go back to commitment, patients and families, and team cohesion.
I think part of the other thing that was so foundational to the success of this team was there were a couple of people, as Ann Barb and Tanya, who were very much from at the forefront and continued to span throughout many changes throughout the entire project. And their commitment to not only the patient population, their commitment to each other, their commitment to the health center, their commitment to enhancing communication across the team, bringing in various people, making sure that Wanda really did have those gaps filled, and she was so willing to hear them and listen to them, that I think it's not only commitment, it's also resiliency. And so that sense of, if I have to say this one more time, I will, because it's so important, right? So I think that was part of it.
It took about 3 days for in the PICU to have a family who had been in the NICU, or families who have been in PICU and then now in the new PICU, to know that everything that this team put forward came to fruition and it came right. And we've done what we've been successful in the goal that they all set out to achieve, and that shared vision, we got it right. And if it wasn't for them, we would not be where we are today. The area is amazing. And, you know, we definitely are leaders across the country in having such a well-established PICU and NICU right now.
I think you just have to walk through the space and experience it yourselves to even imagine what it must be like for patients and families who have to be here, who don't have the actual choice to have to use it. That I'm just so delighted, proud, and thankful to the whole group for making this such a successful redevelopment, and that it's really going to change the lives of our population.
Thank you, Darlene and Stacy. Now we hear from members of the PICU NICU redevelopment team. NICU redevelopmental leader and manager of the neonatal care team, Tanya Bishop, as well as PICU clinical redevelopment leader and registered nurse, Barb Elsmer. They're going to accept this award on behalf of the team.
I feel very humbled. When I really sit and think about, oh my goodness, Barb, is it over 100 people, really, that have been on this journey with us? And so, yes, to be able to, you know, accept on the team's behalf with Barb, it's, my goodness, I never thought I could learn so much. I get to work every day with the most brilliant group of people, and I have never been filled with such purpose. The work meant so much to me. The redevelopment means so much to me, because I feel that we were in the business of changing lives. And so by being able to have these new spectacular units that Barb and I have dreamed about for so long, and that we had people there with us every step of the way to make it happen, I'm humbled. That's all I can say.
And, it was ironic to get the message from Stacy Burgess that we've been not, because Tanya and I were plotting and planning to nominate the team, not ourselves, but the rest of the supporting team. We set out to physically redevelop the space, but it very quickly became apparent that in order to deliver single room care safely and effectively, we would need a lot of technology brought into the space, a lot of enhancements. So clinical engineering and the IT department have just been like crucial and integral every step of the way. So while it feels really good to be nominated, it's really about the entire team. I feel that there's no support team in the hospital that didn't help us out at some point, whether it was housekeeping, management helping us with moving into the space, having it clean for patients, whether it was logistics of changes in workflow, so through food services, the laboratory, pharmacy, I'm going to leave people out, diagnostic imaging, everybody had a say in the redevelopment. Facilities would have been a great support to us. We had outside consultants. We had project managers, and as Tanya said, we've had a few different people come and go, but certainly the last 2 years we've had Wanda Smith from Ellis Dawn, and she truly pulled us over the finish line and got us through some significant hurdles. So just huge kudos to her. And again, I'll miss teams, but there really wasn't any team that we wouldn't have reached out to at some point for help and advice.
Said Barb, yeah. We really did feel the support of so many teams. And so even for teams that were not directly involved in the redevelopment, I think just putting up with it. My goodness, it went on for years. And you know, if we, Barb and I said, if closing down the hallway here at the end doesn't do us in, like, we don't know. So also just want to be able to acknowledge, you know, it was a lot for the health center to go through this. I've never sat and counted up even the displacements that had to happen to make this redevelopment possible. But when I have talked about it, you know, it was clinical engineering who moved their satellite. Pharmacy closed a satellite. You know, the DNA lab moved. The heart center moved. And just all of these things. And then all of us shifting over. It was a lot for the health center. And so I felt really well supported through that too. I mean, Barb and I have been here since the beginning. And we had a lot of passion and heart for the project. I mean, Barb and I, there wouldn't be a week that would go by we wouldn't talk about the children. And so the babies for NICU and the babies and children in, and of course the families. And so we were motivated from the beginning. And so when I think about all of those people who decided to step up and help us and to make this happen and the countless hours they had to put in, I am sure the way it feels to them that there is recognition. And so, you know, Barb and I get to, you know, revel in these beautiful units that we have every day. We get to see the families, we get to see the patients, the difference it's making. But oftentimes when you're involved in the making it happen, you then don't get that reward day in, day out of seeing the difference it's making for the patients and families. And so I think this award that the team can have, it is an acknowledgement and an appreciation, and it does tell them one more time, you were part of something really special, really special, and the work you put in and all that you did, it did not go unnoticed. And so for that, we're so thankful.
Thank you, Barb and Tanya, and the entire redevelopment team for making this dream happen and for your amazing work on behalf of our new NICU and PICU. The next award is the IWK Unity Award. This award celebrates the contribution of a team or individual who's made a concerted effort to create a more welcoming, diverse, and collegial environment within the IWK. The IWK Unity Award honors the spirit of inclusive, hospitable culture where differences are celebrated and respect is demonstrated. Very, very important to our culture here at the IWK. This year's recipient of the award is the EIBI French team. The team was nominated by Catherine Garside of the EIBI team. Let's hear now from Catherine about the winners.
So my name is Catherine Garside. I'm a provincial trainer with the EIBI team. So the nominees for the award were all of our staff at EIBI who are contributing to being a part of programming with French families. Families who are accessing services at EIBI in French. So I worked directly and supported Suli's pod with Leah, Mike, Brianne, Nicole, and Alicia. And also there was, of course, Victoria's pod and everybody working with that team too. I think it's great that they were open to taking on, you know, a new language at work. It's not really an expectation in our role at EIBI, but there are so many French-speaking families and families who would love to send their children both to a French daycare or pre-primary setting and then also have EIBI services complement there. And knowing that the French school board really does appreciate everybody to make an effort to speak in French, it was really helpful for those families, the schools, the child to benefit from having our team's openness to get out there with a little bit of French, even if they didn't know much, just to try. Well, this group in particular was really interested in getting out and practicing a bit of French too. So they wanted to benefit the child and the family and offer that inclusion in our program. But they also went above and beyond. And I know they got together like over some lunch breaks and practiced their French speaking skills together. Or they, you know, took after hours courses, whether it was through, I think the IWK offers some coursework, and then also Mount St. Anne or and they were practicing and even amongst themselves sometimes just trying to get a little bit more French going. So it really does show how this group went above and beyond, not just in the time working with the child with their family or with the child with their school setting, preschool setting. They were also doing it outside of the direct service hours too, practicing their French and being very accepting of that aspect of diversity. Of course, congratulations. Great job, you guys. It's so nice that those families had the opportunity for you guys to practice a little bit of French and help their child in a French learning setting, whether it was at home or pre-primary. It's great work. So proud of all of you.
Thank you, Catherine. Now to hear from the representatives of the IBI French team, speech-language pathologist Lisa Spinney-Hutton, a clinical interventionalist, Victoria Climack, and program implementer Angela Lockard will have a few words.
Hi, bonjour. Je m'appelle Lisa Spinney-Hutton. Je suis une orthophoniste avec EIBI. Hi, I'm Lisa Spinney-Hutton. I'm a speech-language pathologist with EIBI program.
Bonjour, suis Victoria Climack. Hello everyone, I'm Victoria Climack. I'm a clinical interventionist with the EIBI team at IWK.
Hi everyone, my name is Angela Lockhurst and I'm a program implementer with the EIBI program with the IWK.
So I guess thank you very much for nominating us and our team for this award, and it's really appreciated.
Yeah, it's really amazing that that we were nominated, and I feel really grateful for the whole team. And you know, it's nice. I think for myself, it's more so I really recognize the efforts of everyone on the team and the things that they've done. So it's nice that people have recognized that, and hopefully that does prompt others to perhaps kind of pursue similar things, because ultimately it really was, you know, for our clients and the service we provide. So yeah, thank you for recognizing that.
And I also would like to say thank you very much for recognizing our efforts too. I've had a lot of fun doing this, and I hope to learn lots more as we continue to explore more French with more families.
And I know all of us on the team and all of our colleagues, whether or not they're on the same team, work really hard to provide a really culturally and best service to our families. But these teams in particular have worked especially hard, sometimes outside of their comfort zones, I would say often outside of their comfort zones clinically and linguistically. And so it's really lovely to have that recognition for all of that hard work and all of the hours that were put in trying to make sure that we're providing a very safe and inclusive service in French for our francophone and bilingual families. Alors j'aimerais vraiment juste remercier tout le monde. Puis c'est tellement spécial d'être reconnu pour avoir la possibilité d'être capable de donner des services en français. Je sais que c'est pas toujours évident. Puis les membres de l'équipe ont travaillé très fort, mais je sais aussi que nos familles francophones et bilingues et les enfants qui sont là pour communiquer en français, que c'est vraiment apprécié, puis qu'on peut faire une différence pour faire sûr que la langue et la culture de nos familles sont encore là, même si que l'enfant a besoin de soutien, que la famille et l'enfant sont soutenus en français. Alors c'est très, très apprécié.
Say thank you too very much. I feel very proud to be receiving this award. We've done a lot of work together as a team, and we still are going to continue to learn more and grow more as a team. And so thank you very much. It's a real honor to be receiving this award.
Merci.
Merci beaucoup.
Thank you all, and congratulations to the EIBI team. Lastly, another award that's near and dear to my heart, our Workplace Safety Champion Award. This award acknowledges an IWK employee who contributes to the achievement of our organization by supporting a strong culture of health, safety, and also it positively influences the work environment. This individual leads by example in ensuring the psychological and physical safety of those offering and receiving care at the IWK. This year's winner is program educator Prasanna Kariyawasa. of Mental Health and Addictions. Prasanna has nominated by his colleague, an IWK consultant, Krista Stoltz. Let's hear from Krista about her nomination of Prasanna.
I'm Krista Stoltz, and I'm the safety consultant here at the IWK. I nominated Prasanna for the Workplace Safety Champion Award. Prasanna's amazing. I can't say enough about him. He lives and breathes safety. And when I'm talking about safety, he thinks about people's physical safety and he thinks about their psychological safety. Out of all 3,200 staff, I have yet to meet someone who is involved in both staff safety and patient safety in this organization as he is. Prasanna always makes time to help mitigate risk within any given situation, no matter how busy his schedule is. He's very busy. He's an NVCI presenter. I have asked him on many occasions when we have someone who's injured, has a workplace injury, to take the time and assess their ability to return to work with their NVCI, because we have to make sure that they can still participate in NVCI to come back to work. And that's something that a regular physio clinic or an OT clinic cannot test for me. So he takes the time out of his busy schedule to accommodate that, works with the people and make sure that they're feeling comfortable both psychologically and physically, and that they can demonstrate that ability. And he doesn't have to do that, but he does it. And that's invaluable to me as a person who's trying to do claims management. I couldn't do it without him. So I would like to clone him if I could, but he can't. When he's looking at anything, he looks at it both from a patient safety lens and a staff safety lens, and that's how the entire organization should be doing it. And he role models that every day. So I'm very grateful to him. That's just a little teeny bit of the reasons why I nominated him for this award. Congratulations, Prasanna. Nobody deserves it more.
Thank you, Krista. Now we'll hear from Prasanna as he accepts this award.
I want to thank Krista Stoltz for nominating me for this award. I really appreciate Krista thinking about me, because I know that there are numerous people to pick from. I would also like to acknowledge the work that Krista does to identify, establish, and maintain safety for all people across IWK Health. I know that Krista works tirelessly as an invaluable asset to IWK Health. So thank you, Krista. As an employee in the Mental Health and Addictions program for many years, I learned very quickly that safety is very serious and paramount for all patients, so not just patients in the Mental Health and Addictions program, but in all of our services at IWK Health. And also for their families and visitors who are in our care areas. And as a member of the trauma-informed care team now, I also value the safety of the workforce, which consists of employees, physicians, volunteers, learners, and residents. So when I think about staff safety, something I would like to highlight is the need to further our understanding and work around psychological safety needs of all people. So it's not just the workforce, but obviously patients and clients and families and visitors as well. We as IWK Health has made great advances in this area over the past few years, and yet, like many things, there's so much more to be done. And continuing to focus on psychological safety, in particular for staff, is quite important, and I know we're on it, we're continuing to do the work, but I'd just like to highlight that as a specific area that we should continue to work on. And that's because it lets all care providers, whether you're direct care provider, indirect care provider, or support staff, experience a fulfilling career in our chosen professions. So I'm excited to be part of the work that IWK Health has committed to in terms of improving the physical and psychological health of patients, families, visitors, and the workforce. I want to say thank you for this award, and again, thank you to everyone else who continues to work diligently to create safety for everybody else. Thanks very much.
Thank you and congratulations, Prasanna. So today we've seen and heard from a number of wonderful people, people who have nominated their colleagues for awards because they appreciate the good work that they've done, and have, you know, set a highlight of our day today as we start to think about all of the wonderful contributions that are made day after day after day by the wonderful people who work here at the IWK. I take immense pride of being the leader of an organization where we have people such as those who won the awards today. Listening to all of the contributions and successes of the IWK staff and physicians grounds me in what our purpose here at the IWK is, and how very fortunate we are to have the wonderful talent of people that we do within this organization. So today we've highlighted the winners of our 9 annual awards. Next month, we will have another virtual celebration for the remaining awards that we have throughout the year. Until then, stay safe, stay well, and appreciate each other.